So thank you very much. So yes, thanks also to Emmanuel who did this presentation, and I'm here on his behalf because he could not come for visa problems. So today, in the next minutes, I will present the decentralized health model with a comprehensive, preventive, and curative pediatric package that MSF Spain is implementing in Niger. I will follow the following structure, a little bit of background, objective, methodology, preliminary results, and conclusion. So as a background, the project is implemented in Busa district in the region of Tawa in Niger, and we know in that area that most causes of death are very well known and avoidable. They are the main killers. So malaria, acute respiratory infection, and diarrhea. But we know also that almost half of the deaths are also due to malnutrition. In this particular area, the project is in a health area that is called Tama, that has 60,000 population. And we know in that area, 75% of the infants and women in rural community do not have geographical access to the health services. In addition, only 52% of children aged 12-23 months are fully vaccinated in Niger. So all this rationale behind is what it has been considered in the design of the project. So the main objective of the project is to quantify the effect of this decentralized model with these different components in infant morbidity and mortality. And more in a specific way, what we will present today is the result of the specific objective to assess the program's effect in terms of vaccination coverage and nutritional status. So looking at the methodology, what is the package, no? What it consists on? So the target group is children that we are enrolled from birth to 23 months, and they are enrolled in a three-year running program with different components. The preventive component, the curative, and the health promotion component. The preventive component has several activities. One is the seasonal malaria chemo prevention during the malaria peak season that in fact is being implemented by the Ministry of Health. Then there is a vaccination following the full national policy, including polio, BCG, pentavalent, rotavirus, pneumococcal, measles, and yellow fever, up to 1 year, but also with a catch-up up to 2 years. And these vaccines are also provided by the Ministry of Health in this package. Then there is the growth monitoring component, where there is the anthropometric measurements follow-up of all these group of children. And finally, there is a nutritional component based on a lipid-based nutritional supplement of a small quantity. This is called the NutriButter that is providing to every child one sachet per day, and this is represents 120 kilocalories per day. So mothers are sensitized to give one sachet per day to their children. Then the curative component is targeting the main killers following the case management of the national policy in Niger, and also with a deworming component with albendazole. And finally, the last comment is one of the most important also is the health promotion component, where through 160 health community health workers, they are ensuring that all the mothers are bringing the children to the facilities. And also there is an important engagement of the community leaders supervising themselves, the community health workers. Then, there are two main characteristics of this package, and it's the decentralization and the integration. If we look at the pyramid, where there are the different levels of health system, we can see that all the activities are run in the lowest level, so at the community health center, health post, let's say. And then only one health worker from the Ministry of Health is providing all the package. And then we follow also for case management the national policy. Then only some 7 MSF staff are supporting this in terms of supervision and also in the terms of supporting the operational research part component of the project. We have done an estimation of child cost in the first 11 months of the project, and has been 27 euros per child during all this period. Being clear that this cost does not include the vaccines, because are provided by the Ministry of Health, and does not include the seasonal malaria chemoprevention, also provided by MOH. So this is, following the methodology, a three-year open cohort where data collection is monthly. So all the cohort of children are coming every month to the monthly visits in addition to the curative visits. Data collection is following Epidata database. This has been approved by MSF Ethic Review Board and National Ethic Committee. And as a monitoring system, we are implementing annual periodic cross-sectional surveys of different indicators like vaccination coverage, malnutrition prevalences, anemia, and mortality, of course, and including target, so our TAMA health area, and also control population. So these are really the preliminary results. Are the first analysis. It's a very young, let's say, project, as it started in March 2015. So these are the preliminary results. So here in this graph, we show the average vaccination coverage by antigen of the cohort. We don't have yet the data from the cross-sectional surveys. So we can see the overall vaccination coverage increase for all antigens by at least 25%. If we look, for example, at the left side, the pneumococcal 3, there is a 44% of increase, no? As an example. And I forgot to mention that the whole cohort today is 3,548 children. And then another preliminary result is looking at the malnutrition prevalence. So, looking at enrollment, what was the severe acute malnutrition and in program, let's say, after these 11 months. So we have seen also a reduction of the 32% in severe acute malnutrition by weight, Hedget score, and edema, it is an indicator, and a reduction of 21% in the moderate acute malnutrition. So as a conclusion, the most important for us is that this model is a different approach, let's say, for MSF as our standard way to do the things usually. No? So because with very less financial support, no? Less resources, and no including any additional human resources in the health post, we have achieved, let's say, quite positive results. So in fact, the final goal as a long term of this project was to be able to empower the Minister of Health to replicate and even to scale up this package in other health areas. So thank you very much, especially to the field teams who has worked with very enthusiasm and professionalism with this project. And of course, the communities and the mothers and children that are coming monthly to our project, let's say. So sincerely, thanks to all of them. Thank you for your attention.